Good morning students, welcome back. Today we are going to learn the very important topic, curl and divergence. Let's start. So before going to discuss about curl and divergence, we'll start with some example. Suppose there is a fluid moves down in a pipe or river flows, or maybe air circulates in a room. So in all these examples, the velocity can be different at different points or maybe at different times. So the velocity is a vector field which gives the direction of flow and speed of flow at each and every point. Isn't it? So means wherever there is a change, definitely we have to go for differentiation. Now here, to differentiate the vector fields, we are taking two kinds of operations. One is divergence, another one is curl. So these symbolic representations we will discuss in coming slides. So anyway, you may come across in many engineering applications like mechanics, electric, magnetic fields, fluid motions, heat transfer. So these just I listed out. There are many applications and I am going to give certain equations for these applications at the end of this topic. So these are certain examples in vector field. So you may think about aeroplane wing. So when air flows around this aeroplane wing, so how flow will be there? We are just given the directions. Here in a flow of blood, see in the center flow will be very fast. So this is one more example how flow, blood flow is considering as a vector field. And here we are taken two positive charges. So you can see here the lines of force around these two positive charges. See, now as I said, when you want to differentiate on vector field, you should know about these two things, divergence and curl. We'll start with the divergence. So to understand the divergence, we have to define one term. Most frequently it will occur, that is called flux. So a flux of a vector field is the volume of the fluid flowing through an element surface area for unit time. So at any instant time or unit time, so let me see here, this is flow in some pipe. Let you assume like that. So at some point of time in a ring, it is very thin line, okay, thin ring will be there. So how much the volume of the fluid is coming in this area and going outside, okay, in this portion or maybe in this portion, right? So in what we can define the divergence? The divergence of a vector field is the flux. Flux is nothing but volume of the fluid through an element area of the element area for unit time. So divergence is the vector field. Divergence of a vector field is the flux for unit volume. What is the meaning of this? So we'll consider infinite seminal some cubes. You can take it as a point. Okay, so at that particular point, what will be the rate of change of density of the fluid at that point? Okay, so you can thought of like the rate of change of density of fluid at that point. So that is simply some number. So divergence of a vector field will be the number. So we are going to define that. So here The divergence measures, sources or drains of flow. We'll discuss all these terms because these are new terminology for you. When I will introduce about the physical interpretation of these divergence, I will talk about source, sink, no source or sink. This particular diagram also I will discuss in that particular slide. Let's move. So anyway, mathematically I am considering vector field, maybe two dimensional vector field, divergence at some point. Here this black dot is the point. At this point, how the fluid is diverging towards in all directions I shown you here. So as I said, even for three dimensional also, instead of taking all together, see here, just I am zooming at some point. This is also point only. At infinitesimal cube, how fluid is diverging from this cube. So I shown the arrow mark outside only. Fluid is diverging outside. It may be sink also. All this we'll discuss in our physical interpretation of our divergence when I explain. So now mathematically I am defining. So there is a vector field F bar. Okay, F bar may be velocity or force. Okay, whatever it may be, that F bar. So divergence of F, div is the short name, div of F bar, which we will write it up as dou p by dou x plus dou q by dou y plus dou r by dou z, means we are going to get it some scalar value. How you got it? Divergence we can represent with the help of a differential operator as del dot F bar. Do you remember the del operator definition? What is the definition? I dou pi by dou x, j dou pi by dou y. I am not able to write here with mouse. So I think you remembered I dou pi by dou x. I dou by dou x plus j dou by dou y plus k dou by dou z. Isn't it? So this is your function now. I am multiplying del operator with this function. So here your F bar is pi plus qj plus rk. Okay. When I multiplied this del operator, I dou by dou x plus j dou by dou y plus k dou by dou z. This is your del operator. When I multiplied this with your F function, this one, that means pi plus qj plus rk, then I dot I, because it is a dot product, so I dot I is 1, j, I dot I is equal to j dot j is equal to k dot k, all our values are equal to 1. So simply I will partially differentiate p function with respect to x, q function with respect to y, r function with respect to z. Here I will get some scalar value. So here the key point is, when f is a vector, the divergence of f is always scalar. Okay? Right. Now we will understood very clearly with the help of some physical interpretation. So I am considering here, if a fluid is compressible fluid, means it is allowing you to compress, then the divergence of its velocity field measures to what extent it is expanding or contracting at each point. So I just consider here one point for expanding as well as compressing. Okay. So intuitively, If fluid is expanding at this point, here I took x naught, y naught, then the line of flow, the lines of flow would be diverge there. Okay? Since the fluid would be flowing out of a small rectangle about xy. Why it is rectangle? I just took xy on xy plane. I am not taken 3D. So let you think in that way. So the divergence of the velocity will be positive. When it is expanding outside, then that will be the divergence we will consider as a positive. When it is compressing, that fluid is compressing, then we can say that will be the divergence would be the negative. Okay. So the point of here, at some point, the point of expansion or compression in a fluid, these are sometimes we will call it as a sources. So here this is coming out, fluid is coming out, expanding, so we will call it as a source. And here when it is compressing, then we can call it as a sinks. Sometimes we will call it as losing into it. Okay, right. So in some fluids there may not be no sources of or no sinks for incompressible fluid. If fluid is not incompressible, then we can say that there may not be any sources or sinks. So those fields we'll call it as solenoidals. Okay. So of course that part we'll discuss in our coming lecture. The divergence of velocity field of such a fluid would be zero at every point. If there is no source and there is no sink, then that will be incompressible fluid. So for your understanding, I will take one example, very nice example everybody knows. So let you open the tap under the sink. Okay. So the tap, when tap under the tap, water will comes out and it will fall down at certain point and it will expand like this. It will expand like this. In that case, that fluid is expanding, so that the divergence of the fluid will be positive. When it goes to the hole, near to the hole, it is going to be sink in this way. So in that case, we can say that it is compressing, and otherwise something going into that, so that we can call it as a sink. Okay. So this is, in that way we can understood, but all these things are happening at one point, that you keep in mind. Okay, we are just defining at certain point. If divergence of f of x naught y naught equal to 0, then we can say that these are solenoidal vectors, that a vector field is solenoidal vector field, that we will discuss in our next class. Okay. Still, if you are not understood, again we will go through this particular slide. Still so many examples I am given for our understanding. So the divergence of F at a point in a fluid is a measure of rate at which fluid is flowing away from or towards to that point. Okay, so that we can, at some point only we are considering, how the rate of flow fluid away from that point or towards to that point. So when we can say it is a positive divergence, when it is going away from that point. Okay, so when it is negative, when it is coming towards to that point. Right. So, and as I said, if there is no gain or loss of a fluid, then the divergence of F, okay, del dot F will be equals to 0. So as I said, such a vector fields we are calling as solenoidal. So we are going to do problems on this particular topic in our next class. Right. So there are certain applications, as I said. So for the magnetic field, del dot B, okay, is equal to zero. So that means there is no sinks or no sources, so that magnetic field is a solenoidal field. Okay, it is written as file, but this is wrong. Solenoidal field. Right. So see, in that case, there is no loss or gain. That's why del dot B is equal to zero. So here del dot E for electric field is equal to rho by epsilon. Okay, so that means there may be a positive divergence will be there. Okay, so this diagrams will tells you that divergence of F of P means at that point. That's why I written here. Del dot F bar at the rate of P is greater than 0. If it is positive, then it will be the source. Del dot F bar at that point is less than 0, then it will be sink. Del dot F bar equal to 0, then there may not be any source or sink. Okay. Right. Next, I will define the next important term, curl. So what is meant by this? So it is very simple topic. So curl of a vector field, usually the measures the tendency of the vector field to rotate about a point. So let you take some points in the vector field anywhere. Okay, in particular at these points, when the fluid is coming towards this point, how that in that particular, at this point, how fluid is behaving, whether it is rotating with the help of this axis or not. So I just zoomed it here, just I shown you here. At some point when it is rotating, see here the definition, the curl of a vector field at a point is a vector. So when it is rotating, obviously it's a vector, it has its magnitude as well as direction, isn't it? So that rotation, when vector field takes a rotation at some point, then that we can considering as curl at that point. So mathematically, how we are defining, I have vector field of 3D pi plus qj plus rk. So this is curl F, and with the differential operator, we'll write it up as del dot F bar, sorry, del cross F bar. Del dot F bar is for your divergence. Del cross F bar is for your curl. Okay. This is cross product. Previous one is dot product. For divergence, we are using del dot F bar. Here, del cross F bar means curl definition. So while writing curl definition, better to take in this form, matrix form, det of ijk, unit vectors we will write in the first row, second row partial derivatives, dou by dou x, dou by dou y, dou by dou z, and pqr your, the components of your vector, okay, that you write down in the last row. So when you are finding the det of this, we will get these terms, dou r by dou y minus c. Suppose I into, I have to take this multiply, dou r by dou y minus dou q by dou z. This is your first term. So just you find the det value, you will get it. So no need to remember this formula. You please remember this. This is enough to find it out your curl F bar. It's nothing but del cross F bar. So what is the key point here? If F is a vector, then curl of F is always vector. In divergence, what will happen? If F is a vector, divergence of F is always scalar. Do you remember? Just go back. So here, the divergence of a vector field, see, F is a vector, the divergence of F is always scalar. Okay, so this is mathematical, we will define what exactly the meaning, physical interpretation of this curl. Let us check here. So I have certain, I'm just considering again here fluid velocity, velocity of the fluid at some point. So at some point, if you are measuring the rotation of the fluid at some point, okay, so then that will become your curl. So if there is no rotation, rotation is not happening at some point, let you take here some point is there in this infinite seminal, in this infinite seminal cube, in here also some point, at some point rotation is happening. So if rotation is happening, okay, if rotation is not happening, then we can call it as curl F bar is equal to 0. Of course, it is diverging here. And here, curl F bar not equal to 0 means rotation is happening here. Right? So, del cross F bar equal to 0, then in that case, that vector field, we can call it as irrotational, means it is not rotating at that point. At that time, this field, vector field, I can call it as conservative vector field. So in physics, we usually call these terms. Right. So the curl is also enters into electrical engineering, such as electric and magnetic fields. Okay. As you, when you consider magnetic field, which is denoted by H, so del cross H is equal to J. And in case of electric field, which is denoted by E, del cross E always equal to your zero vector. This is zero vector, isn't it? When you have cross product, you will get the vector. Even you should not call it as a zero. It's a zero vector. Okay. So as I said, there are certain applications in our engineering like heat transfer, fluid mechanics, electromagnetics. So, of course, these two topics are very important for our mechanical engineers, and electromagnetics for electronics and telecommunication engineers, and electronics and communication engineers, they may be utilize this. Anyway, I hope all these basic problems, basic equations, you may be come across in your physics also. So, in these equations, mathematically when you modeled, if you see that del dot Q, here some Q means some maybe charge related thing here what we consider. Okay, conservative of heat energy. So maybe rate of that heat related thing. So here heat flux, okay, what we are considering here. And of course this is your heat equation. Do you remember heat equation dou square pi by dou x square at t? So this del operator we are representing with the del operator here. Okay, so the, of course it's second order, not required at this moment. So these are different equations which we are going to form it in fluid mechanics as well as electromagnetics. Please go through that. In all these, if you are observed, either you may have dot product with the del operator or cross product with the del operator. That's why these applications I'm showing here. Please go through this slide carefully while studying. Right. Till now we learned about grad pi, isn't it? Do you remember? Pi is your scalar function and we find grad pi, isn't it? And here divergence. So when I took divergence, I have to take it with a del operator with dot, del dot. If it is curl, then del cross. These are very, very important. Okay. So, del directly, when it is a scalar, directly del pi. It's normal multiplication. When I take it, div, divergence, means I have to take dot product. Del dot vector field. Maybe I have vector field. See, for first one is only scalar field, del pi. So, here, when you are working with the vector field, we should use either dot operator or cross operator. Okay, dot product or cross product. So, del dot F bar is your divergence. Del cross F bar is your curl. Isn't it? Alright. So I'm just written these all these in normally divergence of vector field, curl of a vector field. So what is happening, if you are remembered, when I taken grade pi, always I am getting vector field. Divergence of vector field, just now we saw it's a scalar function. So curl of a vector field, we are getting again some vector. And if you are taken with a different combination of all these, so there are certain important results. You please go through this slide. Whatever I crossed here, these are not at all important for us. The remaining six results are usually important for us. So you just try to understand, especially when you take curl of grade F. Okay, grade F is nothing but your del F. Okay, so del cross del F will be equals to zero vector. Similarly, divergence of curl F. Okay, so that will be, will get it zero value, that is a scalar. So these are some important combinations. You please go ahead, just see it, and then while working with the problems, this combination will help us. Okay, so let's start the problems. Problems are very simple. So if R is a position vector, so usually when it is a position vector in the space, I will take xi plus yj plus zk. So I'm taking position vector as xi plus yj plus zk, we are assuming. Then I have to find it out, divergence of R bar, curl of R bar. So divergence of R bar, so divergence means del dot of R bar. So what is the del operator formula? I dou by dou x plus j dou by dou y plus k dou by dou z dot your R. R is xi plus yj plus zk. So then I dot I value, j dot j, k dot k, all these values equal to 1. Therefore, when you multiply this, with the dot product, dou by dou x of x is 1. Similarly, dou by dou y of y is 1. Dou z by dou by dou z of z is 1. So the answer is here 3. Divergence of R is 3. So when I need to find it out curl R, nothing but del cross, isn't it? We have to apply cross product. So as I said, always you try to write down this into determinant form. So ijk unit vectors in the first row, second row partial derivative, dou by dou x, dou by dou y, dou by dou z. And third row, we have to write your vector components here. So where is your vector here? This is your vector. So here F1, F2, F3 means this is F1 is x, F2 is y, F3 is z. Okay, here. So right. So this is your matrix. So find its determinant. This is your determinant. So you just find its delta of this value, we are getting zero vector. So it's very simple. While finding the determinant, dou by dou y of z means that is zero only, minus dou by dou y of z. See, with respect to z, y value is zero. So of course that is the reason all values we got zero in this problem. So here we need to find the divergence curl of a vector field, some vector field F bar at this point. So they are given this vector field, and we need to find divergence of F, nothing but del dot F. So we have del operator, multiply with F bar, so del dot F bar, so that will give us your some scalar function, will get it. So at this point, you will get the scalar value, okay, divergence of F. When you need curl F, I have to multiply del cross F bar. As I said, ijk is your first row, second row is partial derivatives, third row is components of this your vector field, F1, F2, F3. This is F1, this is F2, and this is F3. Okay, so that we will take here and just find its dead value. We will get curl F function, we will get it initially. At this point, you please find by substituting in place of x, y, z, substituting this point, we will get that vector. find the divergence and curl of a vector f bar, okay, if f bar is equal to grad of this. So directly f bar they are not given this time. F bar is equal to some grad. What is the meaning of grad? Do you remember? Grad is nothing but del. Del of this. So what is this? It's a scalar function, isn't it? So del pi. So you know how to get it, del pi. So del is nothing but I dou by dou x plus j dou by dou y plus k dou by dou z. So this, when we are multiplying with this, okay. So I dot I is 1, I into this whole scalar function with respect to x, we are finding, plus j into dou by dou y of this function. So we are going to get it, this vector field. You know very well this vector. How to find grad pi, nothing but del pi. So anyway, we have vector field now. What is the problem in this? They are not given vector field directly. So that we find. After that, we need to find divergence and curl for this vector field. So how to get a divergence of f? Del dot f bar, as it is. Okay. Curl formula, del cross f bar. So just use these formulas and simplify, you will get it. Sometimes they will give some point. See here, divergence of f, I got scalar function. Because they are not given the point, just leave like that. Here also, of course, curl f, you got zero vector. Right. We have now here, vector field is there, no problem. And we need to find f bar dot curl f bar. So first we'll find curl f bar, then after that we'll multiply with your vector field f bar with the dot product. So we have f bar and we have curl, we need to find curl f bar, nothing but del cross f bar. First we find that, we got the vector here. Curl f bar is one vector and f bar is also the given vector field. So this is also vector and curl f bar is also vector. When I multiply both vector with the dot product, vectors with the dot product, I will get the scalar value, that is 0. Now, in this problem, we need to find curl of curl A bar. So, we have A bar which is a vector field. Curl A bar means del cross A bar. So, first you find that curl A bar. After that, again one more time, curl A bar you got now here. Then curl of curl A bar means, that means it is simply del cross curl A bar already, that is del cross A bar, that we will multiply, okay. So one more time, for this we are taking these values are F1, F2, F3. So we will write here. So it is like an iteration process, right. So curl of curl A bar is nothing but del cross of del cross A bar. So already del cross A bar you find, again one more time, del cross of del cross A bar you find. So that we, again we are taking in this. So I hope so you understood this. Next. Right. So in this problem we need to, they are given scalar function, see. These are different problems we are working. So now I need to find it out, divergence of grad pi. So we have pi, very easily we can find grad pi, that will become some vector, isn't it? So here, and they are not given at certain points, that's why we have this vector. And we need to find a divergence of grad pi, means divergence is mean del dot of del pi. Okay, so you know the del operator. So del operator is I dou by dou x plus j dou by dou y plus k dou by dou z, that is multiplied with this vector grad pi. So when you multiplied I dot I, j dot I, k dot k equal to 1, so remaining we have to do partially with respect to x, y, z. You just simplify, you will get this result. Very, very simple problems. Only concept wise, if you understood, these problems are very simple. So now we need to find in this problem divergence of f and curl of f. And I was given grad. F is not directly given. f is equal to grad of some scalar function given to you. So of course you will find f is equal to del pi, this is grad pi. So from that you will get your vector field. So we got your vector field. After getting vector field, we need to find it out divergence of f and curl of f. So of course this is the divergence of f, del dot f bar, curl. At some point if they ask, we have to substitute the point also. So divergence of f at this point is minus 32, it shows the negative direction. And then curl of f at del cross f bar, that will find it out. And at some point if they are given to you, curl, this is also given at this particular point, if you substitute that point, this will becomes zero vector. Okay, so these problems are very very easy and simple, and hope so you understood these problems. If you have any doubts, please ask me in the next class.